instills a positive view of Africa, her people, and her many cultures that span the globe and bind us all together in a global shared community. The Akwamu State in Ghana, West Africa, being part of the global shared community, is rich in culture and tradition. Akwamu was a 16th century prominent and powerful empire with land territories covering much of the southern part of the present-day Ghana. Many ethnic groups in Ghana trace their roots of customs and traditions to the Akwamu State. My brothers and sisters, if you want to talk about the Akwamus, we will talk and talk until the cows come home from grazing. I'll tell you a special relationship between the Akwamus and the Danes. In our history, first, the king of Akwamu was given a special sword by King Frederick of Denmark for his bravery during the Akatamansu War about the year 1826. After the Akatamansu War, the King of Akwamu was invited by King Frederick to come and dine with him. During that meeting, the King of Denmark gave the king of Akwamu golden cutlery. The cutlery is still here in Akwamu, as is true earlier. Akwamus, in their quest to conquer everybody, after conquering the coastal state of Accra in around 1680, the year 1680, Akwamus wanted to gain total control of the coast, but the Danes were in the Usu Christian Broadcaster. The king of Akwamu and one of the royals, Anakasimeni, managed to hack a plan which in 1693, Asimeni, with a disguise of about 80 men, managed to enter the Usu Christian Broadcaster. Disguised themselves as traders and attacked the governor of the castle and his people from within. The castle was seized and Asimeni lived there as a governor for 14 good months. After 14 months, the king of Denmark renegotiated for the castle to be sold back to them. But Akwamu came opted for one thing, that before he gave the castle back to them, change all the laws of the castle and give the original keys to him as a trophy. I am inspired by the strength of the youth leaders at us and all the people of the African diaspora. May you continue to grow with love and peace for one another. And as youth leaders of African descent, always, always, remember, you are the true descendants of survivors of the slave trade. Thank you very much.